It's a hidden ingredient hidden under a napkin.
We got some good foam.
We got a lot of foam.
We got some good foam.
We're gonna put some fresh lime juice in here. We're gonna put a lot, actually.
Oh, I'm very allergic to lime.
Are you serious? Hey everyone, my name is Philip Wang. Welcome to Spill the Boba Tea, a show where I bring over special guests to Boba Mofa Cafe for a special drink making experience where we craft a unique beverage that's based on my guest's life and career. Tonight we have an extremely talented young man with us. You might have first seen him on Silicon Valley or Crazy Rich Asians or one of his many comedy specials or maybe his mukbangs on YouTube. His movie Love Hard is coming to Netflix this holiday season. Please welcome Jimmy O Yang.
Woo!
We're here, baby.
Jimmy, welcome to the show. Thank you so much for being here. I'm really excited to make this special drink for you tonight. There's a lot of ingredients in this. This is a very special drink. Don't look yet. Let's start off with our first ingredient, which is based off of where you were born. We have some green tea here.
Oh!
Of course.
Of course.
You grew up in Hong Kong. Tell us about, you know, what area of Hong Kong you grew up in. Like, what are your memories?
Yeah, man, it was pretty wild. Totally different experience. It's like New York.
Yeah.
You know, people think about Asia, they don't really think like big concrete jungle cities necessarily.
I remember the first time I went to Hong Kong, I'm like, this is insane, just how tall these buildings are.
Yeah, and even like playing soccer, I grew up playing soccer, there's no grass. You just play on the concrete. So if you fall, you go home for the day. Like, that's it, your knee's bleeding.
Right.
You know? So it was definitely like culture shock coming here to America. Parks actually have grass.
And your soccer game like went up like after like, oh my God, I'm invincible here.
I was extremely mediocre in Hong Kong, but when I came to America, I could have made the high school team, but I just didn't go to the tryout because it was like 6 a.m.
Well, I'm just trying to imagine basically, you're like I feel like we all have that cousin that like moved over a little later. Like, I'm like, I know exactly who you are.
That cousin. Cause I have cousins here that are ABCs, you know, American born Chinese. And we were culturally so different.
Yeah.
Like, I remember they just called my dad Richard.
Yeah.
Instead of calling my dad uncle, whatever. My dad was like furious.
Wait, no, I mean, hey, I'm an ABC. I still know not to call like any Asian parent.
Yeah, maybe they were just dicks. I don't know.
It's not like it's
no, they're very nice people. But it was just culturally, they're very Americanized. Right, and I was extremely Chinese.
Yeah.
I came to America, like first year was middle school, eighth grade. Very hard transition here.
Oh my gosh, middle school's already tough.
Yeah, and also I didn't like go to a high school, middle school in San Gabriel Valley or like NorCal where there's a lot of Chinese people. I felt very, I had to assimilate. Yeah. I couldn't just be like Asian. I'm okay now.
So, well, let's move a little bit ahead in your life because the next ingredient we have is actually related to where you went to college.
Oh. Okay.
You went to school at UC San Diego.
Yeah.
Guess what? I went to school at UC San Diego.
No way.
Yeah.
Which college were you
at? I was Revell.
Oh man.
What were you again?
I was Six College, the new one that they never named.
So Wes, the co-founder of Wong Fu, was Six College too.
No way.
So I'm class of 06 and you're 09, right?
Well, I was supposed to graduate in 09, but I graduated 2010.
Yeah. Right. So we technically overlapped in some way.
That's so wild. Did like, you at party? Least like where did you hang out? See, I was like depressed during college. Hated UCSD.
Oh, you should have found me, man. I had a blast.
Man, we could have hung out, bro.
I was involved in like this like dance group. That was like my
So
tribe.
You were like cool.
I mean, how cool are organized dancers?
Yeah, well, how cool could you possibly be in UCSD? Where we have Division III basketball teams
that's
and
true.
Nothing.
Yeah, that's
and our mascot is a fucking Triton.
Hey, you watch what you say about UCSD.
You know what? I don't like UCSD, man. It was too academic.
Oh, okay.
Everybody just hung out. The guys at the library studying. It wasn't a quarter system.
Yeah.
There was really no college fun life.
So that might be you going to the college expecting the American like style of
NCAA
football games. Yeah, we didn't have that. I'm very sorry.
No, don't be sorry. Are you a UCSD representative?
No,
don't have to be sorry. You're like, UCSD's great. I encourage you to go to UCSD. Are you doing that?
I was a commencement speaker in 2016. So
really?
I'm on that level, I guess. But this isn't about me. This is about your
I'm not trying to one-up you, but they also invited me. They asked if you want to do some kind of a speech.
And you said,
No, I didn't say that. I was like, yes, but you gotta understand I hated my college experience.
Which
and it's very dangerous. Right. If you hire me, do you still want it? And they never emailed me back. But you know what? I would say this, my commencement speaker was Mike Judge.
And we're gonna get into that. Yep. You took my segue, but before we get into that segue.
Segues are overrated.
Because we went to school at UC San Diego. We got to bring out some tequila.
Oh, yeah?
Because I read a story of you going to TJ while you were down there.
Everybody wanted TJ.
Everyone goes to TJ when you're in San Diego. It's like an hour from the border.
Yeah.
You know, we just thought we'd, you know, spice things up, bring some alcohol. This is the first time of all the episodes that we're going to be doing an alcoholic boba beverage.
Whoa! This is new.
Yeah, we're taking it up a notch. But what was your craziest TJ experience?
Oh, mine is kind of like sad crazy.
Of course, everything about UCSD or San Diego was sad.
It was sad. Okay. Like, it wasn't like, oh, I got left in a strip club or like whatever, right? Yeah. Like, it was not, it was like, okay, we went to party in TJ and then I came back, all my friends got through in the border, whatever. And then I was like, oh man,
oh, no.
I forgot to bring like my green card and like, you know, or my driver's license.
Yeah.
And my white friend Ian in front of me was like, yo, just tell me you're an American citizen and let you right through. I was like,
yeah.
Easy for you to see, guy.
Yeah.
And then I went up, I was like, and then the first question they asked you, they're like, are you an American citizen? Because if you are, they let you right through, right? They punch in the computer. I was like, yeah. And I wasn't. Oh. I had a green card at the time.
Oh no.
And then they detained me. I was like in the basement of the border. I was still drunk. I just partied. My friends was up there waiting for me for like 2 hours. I couldn't call nobody. I definitely couldn't call my parents.
What did you think was going to happen?
I thought I could have gotten deported. They threatened me. They were like, yo, you can't just lie about being an American citizen.
Yeah.
You have a green card. Why did you choose to lie?
That's when you say, 我不懂.
Yeah.
英文.
Yeah.
很难讲.
Yeah.
I don't understand.
Well, then I would have definitely gotten deported.
Yeah.
But I don't know, man. I was just like so panicked. I was on the brink of tears. I'm like, I'm sorry. I'm just a stupid American college student.
Yeah.
Like, I'm so stupid. I'm sorry. I thought it wasn't a big deal. You know, I've been in this country for 10 years. I didn't think about how I could possibly even get deported at this point.
Oh my God.
And then there was like a whole like deliberation like in the back. And then finally they took mercy on me. Whew. They were like, look, you know, just don't ever do this again. Always keep your green card with you. And you could be an American citizen because you've been here for 10 years.
Yeah.
Why don't you do it? I'm like, well, because I didn't have $600 to apply.
Oh,
I was a
God.
Poor college student. I remember this one, the last thing, like a kick in the nuts at the very end was when I was walking out to go back to San Diego, right?
Yeah.
My friends had already left. They thought I died, whatever, right? So as I was seeing like United States of America walking back to the border, one last guard, Asian American brother told me, he was like, don't ever do that again or we'll send you back to where you came from. Can you believe that from an Asian guy,
oh
from a self-hating Asian brother?
Oh, damn.
Like, there's just so much to unpack in that.
Yeah.
And I still haven't been able to do it. But I remember I was so angry and I remember that so vividly.
Yeah.
You know, sure, I was an idiot.
Right.
But homeboy didn't need to say that.
Right.
You
know? It's not necessary.
Yeah.
So you don't need that extra.
Like, I'm already trying to fit in. Like, why is this Asian dude trying to kick me when I'm down?
I'm sorry. Yeah, I'm sorry.
I accept your apology.
All right. Yeah. Well, we're going to pour all this in. We're going to get started. So this is already pre-measured. That's 3 ounces of green tea.
Three ounces.
Why don't you pour this in first? And then we're going to do 3 ounces of tequila.
All right. That's 1.5. Oh, that's beautiful.
Okay.
So we're doing basically 2 shots in this drink.
I think we can handle it. All right, so we're gonna set that aside. We're gonna head over to our next ingredient.
Okay,
so you brought up that Mike Judge was your commencement speaker.
Yeah.
Because Mike Judge was also a UC San Diego alumni.
That's right.
Mike Judge, the reason why you brought him up, the reason why I'm bringing him up is because he was also the creator of Silicon Valley.
That's right.
Which was actually the first show that I saw you on.
Yeah, it's really my big break.
Yeah.
Like, it's my first real job in this town.
Do you remember like the audition process for it?
It was, the audition was like basically like nothing.
Yeah.
Because the part was only 2 lines. And I went in there and I just did it. I felt like I know this character very well.
Yeah.
I got the job. I didn't think much of the job. I was very excited. I was
like, a single episode.
I was like, oh, 2 episodes, great. I'll get $900, you know.
Yeah.
But I did find it very special because it was Mike Judge and I'm a big fan of his and he was my commencement speaker.
Yeah.
And in his speech, he was talking about how he was a physics major, but he hated it so much. So that was kind of low key, like very inspiring for me, who was an economics major, who didn't want to do what I, you know, graduated with.
Yeah.
So I remember the first day I went up to him, I was like, your commencement speech was awesome. And I was there.
Yeah.
And he was just like, oh, really? Cool. Like, you know, he's like not being dismissive. Yeah. That's just how he is. And then we're very close friends still.
That must be a trip for him to see like one of the people in the audience now on his set. Like,
gotta
that's
be actually, wild,
that's
right?
That's a pretty good feeling for him too.
Yeah.
And the fact that you turned two lines into like a series regular.
That was pretty crazy.
That's awesome. Yeah. Like, and I think that's a testament to obviously the show just being amazing, but also like what you did with the character. And I gotta say, I'll be honest. When I first saw your character, I wrestled with it a little bit too.
Sure.
Because, and I think a lot of Asian Americans always wonder like when they see accents and things like that on
camera. Yeah, yeah.
But then I had to check myself. I'm like, wait, we're not trying to get rid of accents, because there are a billion people in this world that are us, that have our face, that have accents. And like you said, these characters exist.
Thank you, man. Yeah. The first year I got a lot of like, even like hate articles. I remember, I think Mashable is an Asian American girl. I don't want to call nobody out, but like she wrote something like, this is a bad stereotype. It wasn't so much about me, but it was about the show.
Sure. Well, the show has a lot of bad stereotypes in general.
Sure, like everybody's in there. Yeah. But for me, like reading that, it was like really disheartening because sure, it was about me as an actor. Yeah. I didn't like that. I was like, why can't you just judge me on my performance?
Yeah.
But secondly, I felt like if you're talking about I can't do an like accent character, that's like you hating my 13-year-old self who had an accent.
Erasing that experience.
Yeah. And I felt like really like upset about that.
Right.
But I do now understand the Asian American narrative of, hey, our stereotype that we got to fight against is the constant foreigner.
Yeah.
And as somebody, as a face on TV and on film, I am very conscious on fighting that.
Like, it's definitely like just like this extra challenge that we have as Asian creators in media, where because we have so few opportunities, we do start to hyper analyze every little thing.
Yeah.
Like when I've said this before on the show too, like we want that spectrum of like that character can exist because it's balanced out with these characters, right?
Exactly. Yeah. And that's why Crazy Rich Asians was like so liberating.
Yeah.
I was just acting. I was just playing a character. I didn't have to worry, because even if I came off like an asshole or whatever, which is what the character was, even if I have a little bit of an accent because I didn't want to do an American accent, there's 10 other people.
Yep.
There's Henry, there's Remy, there's Chris, there's Ronnie, and then there's all the girls. It's just a spectrum of Asians. We can just be human beings and I can just be an actor.
Yep.
But I do absolutely understand that we all have a responsibility to represent.
Yeah.
And I joke about this in my stand-up. It's like, there's a lot of pressure. I almost don't want to represent.
Yeah.
I wish I didn't have to, but it is something I am taking responsibility on, and I'm very passionate about it.
Well, you took the segue away from me, because literally I was going to bring up Crazy Rich Asians next. Because, yes, Crazy Rich was another milestone in your career.
Uh-huh.
And we wanted to make this drink Crazy Rich.
This is the hidden ingredient hidden under a napkin. What is this? It's caviar or gold leaves? It's got to be one of the two, right?
Now, let me ask you this. Would you want to drink a boba drink with caviar in it?
I won't.
So, yes, you're correct. We have gold foil. Yeah, Crazy Rich was definitely that project that allowed for so many other Asian projects to come through.
Yeah.
Because it did really break down a lot of barriers, at least on the mainstream level.
Mm-hmm.
And it did have its kind of controversies in the beginning, because like we were saying, everyone was hyper analyzing this single film because it was the first one in 25 years, all those headlines, right?
Sure.
But how was your experience on it? Like, I mean, aside from all this, the craziness that was going around it.
I loved it. It was an incredible experience because we're all in Singapore. You got like Chinese people or Asian people from America, from, you know, Australia, from Singapore, from wherever, right?
Yeah.
And it's like Justice League coming together. And there is something just so liberating. First of all, I was so proud to see other brothers, Asians, brothers and sisters doing so well. I was like, dang. And then when we're sitting in the lobby, it's like, what are we gonna eat tonight? Let's go get Xiaolong Bao.
Yeah,
Let's go get chili crab. Yeah. And then afterwards, guess what? Let's all go karaoke.
Yeah.
You don't have to feel like you're leaving somebody out, because that's not their life, right? And I just felt so seen and like, I felt so normal for the first time. Instead of like me having to assimilate, everybody was just like me.
Yeah.
And it was an incredible experience. And I was like, you know what? If the audience can feel a sense of that joy, I think the movie's gonna do well.
Yeah. All right, so part of your career that has taken off since Crazy Rich is a lot of Netflix projects.
I am a Netflix guy now.
Space Force, you've been on. Uh-huh. You were just announced recently to be the next voice of the Monkey King.
Yes, which, baby.
That's huge. That's like literally our Batman.
It really is.
Yeah.
It really is. Yeah.
So congratulations on that. You were also in a film called Wish Dragon that's on Netflix right now. I'm in Wish Dragon 2 also.
Oh, who are you?
I'm the red shirt neighbor.
A steady job, a big paycheck.
Oh, nice, nice. I remember
and
the red shirt neighbor.
Slash valet. I got to do two lines.
You did two voices.
Yeah. Chris was great. He threw me
two lines, the director.
Because we're both in Wish Dragon, we share this connection. Mm-hmm. I think you already know where this is going. We got some dragon fruits.
Ooh.
So this is dragon fruit flesh, and then dragon fruit puree that we made in-house, but we strained it. So it's just like all pure dragon fruit goodness.
Okay.
So let's go back to the Monkey King.
Monkey King's very exciting. I'm actually going in this week again.
Cool. I can't wait to see. That's gonna be amazing.
But my voice goes out. I can only do 4 hours at a time.
And
my voice is completely gone.
Yeah.
Afterwards for like a day or two. So yeah. The secret, I guess, to a lot of voiceover actors, even when I talk to non-Asian voiceover actors, they found the secret, and it's our secret, is to pay pot. Go.
Black syrup.
Yeah, yeah.
Wait, are you like so
non-Asians you do it before.
Non-Asians are using pipakao?
I was talking to Ben Schwartz, he knew about it.
What?
Yeah, he's the voice of Sonic, right?
Wow.
So you do it before, one spoon, and then one spoon after. It's like a throat coat that lubricates your vocal cords.
So they already found out about it. It's not like you gave them our secret.
You know? But you know what's funny? I think Ben was buying pipakao from Amazon for like $20 a bottle. And I'm like, Ben, you can buy this shit in any Chinese market for like $4. You know, they're like, so somebody on Amazon is ripping white people off.
They want to pay $20. Don't worry.
That's good.
Like, they feel like it's more premium if they pay more for it.
I just hope it's a Chinese person at least posted on Amazon and profiting off of that shit.
All right, we have one more ingredient, but before we get there, we're going to actually start assembling the drink. So here's your cup. Here's my cup. This is actually our large because, you know, we're ending things on a big note, all right?
It's a good size large.
Yes, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna start off with just putting a little bit of the flesh just at the bottom.
Uh-huh.
And then we're going to actually add 4 ounces of the puree. So you can actually just pour that in.
Ooh.
All right. Obviously this wouldn't be a boba drink without some actual boba balls. So you can put in as many as you want.
Okay. I'm a easy on the boba type of guy.
Right,
you know, I want the flavor to shine through. So let me just do like half a scoop here.
So we were talking about Silicon Valley. We got too enthralled talking about Silicon Valley, but one ingredient that we have to represent Silicon Valley is Topo Chico.
Huh.
And the reason why is because apparently this drink is like super trendy. Silicon Valley is just all about like the trendy, Patagonia vests, the coolers, all these things. Right. So Topo Chico is here to represent Silicon Valley. Yeah. Why did this become so fancy or so trendy?
I think cool people in Austin start liking it. Or that's when I first heard about my buddy's wife is from Austin.
And it probably trickled over to Silicon Valley.
Probably. All the cool kids start drinking.
All the cool kids. Next up is some ice. Just a little bit.
Less ice.
Literally, you could do,
Five cubes.
All right. You're gonna put in as much Topo Chico to hit this in-between line right here.
Mine's all just Topo Chico.
No, trust me, we're not done yet. We have one more ingredient that's gonna go in there. And this is an egg, okay? Because we're gonna talk a little bit about your upcoming film, Love Hard, that comes out during the holidays. Holidays, drink eggnog, we got an egg. How excited are you about this movie to come out?
Extremely.
Yeah.
Tell us what
the movie's about.
Well, it's a very classic rom-com that they just don't make anymore. And I think it's a beautiful film. It's me, Nina Dobrev, and Darren Barnett.
And Harry Shum.
And Harry Shum.
Oh, is that a secret? We can't.
I don't know. I think we can talk about
it.
And it's really cool. Like, I get to be a lead in a rom-com. I don't know how much I could give away because there is kind of like a twist in the movie.
Yeah.
I might be the guy, I might not be the guy. Do I get the girl then?
Oh,
we don't know.
Okay, all right, no spoilers.
We don't know.
But I'm very glad to see you as yet another lead in a movie. Like this is amazing.
Yeah. And I'm like cute in the movie. I'm not hot. Darren Barnett is like hot. He's like the guy that a girl would like to, you know, just have sex with and never talk to.
Sure.
Me,
a
girl will have sex with me and keep talking to me. You know what I mean? But I think it's a very cute and very great film.
Yeah.
Because rom-com is warm and fuzzy, and I think we capture a lot of that.
You're talking to the right guy. I mean, I'm all about rom-coms. Wong Fu is all about, the feel-good romantic stuff. So I'm excited for it. This holiday, we're gonna look out for it, but let's get some egg white from this. Have you ever had eggnog before? During the Christmas time?
No, actually,
that's a very American thing,
too. That's very American, yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So, actually, you're the cook. Get us the egg whites, okay? Have you ever separated
them
before?
I don't know
before?
How to do that.
You never separated
was
the egg
whites? I eat my yolks.
Oh, okay. So you break it first, okay? But then before you let it all come out, you have to try to catch the egg yolk. So you and then you kind of just swing the egg back and forth between the shells.
Whoa!
See that?
Oh, nice.
And then now you just have just the egg yolk by itself and all the egg white.
That's
down
the
there.
Good part. I also got high cholesterol though. I think
we should hold off. Yeah, if you're going easy boba, then you should definitely go easy yolk.
Yeah.
All right, So we're gonna be putting this into the shaker. What this is gonna help us do is actually make a foam.
Oh, okay.
All right, so you can pour that in. Ooh. All right, we're gonna put some fresh lime juice in here. We're gonna put a lot, actually.
Oh, lime I'm juice. Very allergic to lime.
Are you serious?
Yeah. But it's fine, I'll still drink it.
Wait, what do you mean?
No, it's fine.
Do we need an EpiPen here?
No, I just get mucusy, it's fine.
Okay, and it's not like—
Oh, whoa, okay, well, maybe not the second one. Oh, God, okay, take it easy on your boy here, you know? I said I'll play ball, but not like four lines.
Okay, 2.5 ounces of sugar, all right.
Ooh, that's a lot of sugar.
Well, because we're—
Right, because this doesn't really have sugar yet, it's just the dragon fruit natural
exactly
flavors.
Right, exactly. So, I think my arm's gonna get tired because like when we were testing this out, like you gotta shake it really hard. So we might have to tag team this, right? You have to like press really hard. All right, can you give that a shake too? I'm like all wet. There it is. All right, that's much better than me.
I think you're better off doing one hand, right?
Okay. All right.
It's more natural.
More
motion.
Natural. So what we're gonna do now.
Oh, we got some foam. We see some foam.
We got some good foam.
We got a lot of foam.
We got some good foam.
Yeah.
All right, so all we're gonna do is we're gonna top it off.
Well, but if you use a strainer, you're not gonna get the foam.
So when it hits the seltzer water, it's gonna expand a little bit. So don't pour it all the way to the top.
Oh, okay. I'm gonna watch you.
Just watch, here we go.
Oh, cool.
All right.
Why does it expand? What's the science behind that?
Man, I don't know. I make videos.
Keep going. Oh, actually, let's just kill it.
There it is.
Tough, nice.
All right, so what we have here is a dragon fruit, green tea, tequila soda.
Oh, well, don't forget the...
And then we're gonna top it off.
Oh, that flew right on my cup.
So we gotta make this fancy. We're gonna put some gold flakes on here. Oh my God, I'm gonna like make a nice design. Ooh, you're going all in the middle right there?
Yeah, man, you wanna just like, as if I did that.
I see, you wanna do this thing over
this
here.
This is beautiful, Phil.
This looked pretty good.
We gotta name this, no?
Well, that's the thing. Every guest has named their drink.
There's a lot of pressure here. I think it's something, you got a dragon, the purple dragon.
Yeah. Something, you gotta show that it's a cocktail element in there. Like, there's the tequila in there too. It's like spiked dragon.
Spiked dragon. The spiked golden dragon. Yeah, I'll take it.
You'll take that?
Yeah, I'll take it.
All right, this is Jimmy's golden spiked dragon. Woo. Let's mix it up, because you gotta get the dragon fruit. So let's go in there, give it a good stir. Woo! Hey, that's looking nice.
That looks really good.
The seeds like add to the, oh my gosh, that's pretty cool. All right, that's Jimmy, cheers.
Cheers.
Thank you so much for being here tonight. Thank you for making this drink with me. And congrats on Love Heart and everything you got going on, man.
Thanks, man.
Appreciate it. Oh my God.
Whoa.
Yeah, are you getting bits?
Is it the puree? Like that sweetness is really good flavor.
No, this is really good.
Like, I would order this at like an overpriced cocktail bar.
This is like $20.
Yeah.
It's easy.
Right.
I think, do you have something with dragon fruit on your menu?
No, but we might have to now.
Mm-hmm.
Because this is pretty bomb.
No, you should. Like, this is really good.
But anyways, Jimmy, thank you again so much. Let the cameras know, you know, where to find you, where to check out your latest.
You can always find me on Instagram and TikTok at Funny Asian Dude. I'm a TikTok guy now.
You made the jump. And YouTube. You're everywhere, man.
I think I'm like the most watched comic on TikTok for some reason. 12-year-olds love me. I don't know what that says about my material. But also, more importantly, Love Heart is coming to Netflix this holiday. It's a beautiful rom-com, November 5th. And your boy will be a lead on a rom-com.
Love Heart, so hard. Jimmy O Yang, cheers at Boba Mofo. Thank you everyone for watching another episode of Spill the Boba Tea. See you next time. Later.